Thank you, Mr. So, we request you to please stay back. I'll invite Mr. Pradeep Dwivedi, CEO Sakal, to engage in a question and answer session with you. We've got the chairs lined up here, and a very, very insightful and interesting presentation there, talking definitely about the Amul girl. Incidentally, वो जो बच्ची है वो 50 साल की अभी recently हुई है थोड़े ही महीने पहले, and still everybody doesn't mind being tokoed by a little girl. And no change of positioning, I think that is pretty disruptive in itself, because I would probably personally feel that a lot of marketing heads actually join organizations to leave their mark and change positions, spend millions of rupees, and then, you know, try to change around exactly what the legacy has been. So kudos for Amul to be, you know, maintaining that brand positioning. And also, having said that, they've also revitalized the brand and extended the brands into various other categories and products. So, Mr. Pradeep Dwivedi, of course, CEO of Sakal Media Group, an accomplished industry leader with an experience of over 23 years of business management cutting across functions and industry, is an active participant in many industry or associations such as IAA. Thank you so much for all the tweets, Mr. Dwivedi. Also, an honorary secretary and managing committee member, and the Advertising Club of India as a managing committee member. So I request you to engage in a conversation with Mr. Sodhi, and of course, later on, we will take a couple of questions from the floor.
Thank you. Good evening, everybody, and thank you so much, Mr. Sodhi, for a really exciting presentation. I think the audience was looking forward to getting some great insights on Amul, and I think what you presented is, I think, far beyond our expectations. I had come prepared with a bunch of questions that I wanted to ask you, but in all fairness, I think your presentation has actually covered quite a few ground, and I think brought great insights to all of us. So let me ask by asking you something very different. You lead an organization that leads a very iconic brand and connects both the service providers and the consumers in a very unique way. How do you define leadership? How do you maintain your leadership in a market which is extremely competitive, especially for consumer products?
Like I said, winning the blind faith of our two main stakeholders in the brand, that is our milk suppliers and our consumers. And that we have been doing last 70 years, and we have never compromised on such our strategy. That is giving best price for the milk which farmers are giving, and giving best quality tasty product by using the best technology at value for money. And always, in business point of view, always believe in scale, mass system. So that efficiency comes in the system, and you are able to pass on that efficiency either to the supplier or to the consumer. So, you are creating entry barriers so high that your competitors are unable to enter.
That's really unique. One of the things that has always worked for brand Amul is that it has always been very fresh and very consistent in the consumer's mind. You know, today the segmentation of marketing talks about millennials, talks about a new consumers that looks at media and marketing in a completely different way than traditional consumers have looked at. But the brand remains extremely relevant in the eyes of all of these consumers. So how do you keep the brand so fresh? What is the mystery behind it?
We give you fresh milk in the morning when you are very fresh. So we start early morning with the milk, right, and you sleep having a cup of ice cream. Or so the whole day we are with you, so always top of the mind is there. But you see, keeping brand fresh, especially in food products, is easy also and difficult. The reason is that if you see your plate or thali, we call food, I am 57 years. I remember what I used to have during my childhood days. Same thing I am having thali. Wohi subah aloo ke paranthe, sabzi aayegi, gobi ke paranthe, gambhuli ke paranthe. मक्खन होगा, पहले व्हाइट बटर होता था, चलो अभी अमूल का बटर होगा. कर्ड वॉज देयर बट नाउ कर्ड इज पैक, कर्ड इज देयर. वंस इन अ व्हाइल, वंस इन अ मंथ, वंस इन अ वीक मे ट्राई ओल्ड. वी स्टार्टेड विद नॉर्थ इंडियन फर्स्ट वीकेंड्स, मींस ड्यूरिंग चाइल्डहुड साउथ इंडियन. then Chinese came, then Mexican came. Now, I mean, we keep on shifting. But main food in the thali is same. So what is challenge is how to make this food in the thali always fresh that consumer or you always try to eat. So butter maybe 56 years old, but whenever you eat it, you always feel very fresh. And same is true in our campaign or brand building. Utterly buttery delicious, the campaign, the celebrity or whatever CC we are choosing, the girl. She is commenting, which is very, very topical, which is latest. So that is why it is, you feel it is very fresh.
So one of the things that a lot of youngsters in the room, and I'm sure the audience that is looking at it, millions of them through webcast, which is happening right now as we speak, the youth of today is inspired by startups, going entrepreneurial, doing things on their own. When they look at an iconic organization, an iconic brand like Amul, which has created phenomenal success in India and is now a globally recognized brand, what are some of the lessons in organization building that they can draw from you personally and an organization like Amul when they look at creating new products, new services, and making a success out of their startups?
Firstly, let me tell you, startup generally comes to everyone, everyone think only about it, anything which you can do within a room. And that too on computer, on internet, aggregating something. So everybody tries to do that type of thing. But let me tell you, if you want to have ageless organization or startup, you have to see organization where brick and mortar, where field is there. You are interacting with the supplier or consumer. Coming to the food for a young entrepreneur, I like to tell you, there is immense potentiality investing or building brands in food. I mean, Amul last 70s they were there, brand is for more than 60 years. Still, we have got only 5% of the market. So you can see, and only 20% is organized. So enough room, enough market space for others and also for the existing players to grow. But then challenges are also there, especially in food. I have seen, maybe in dairy and other food, why some of the best brands, some of the very good brands, they fail. I have seen people try to come out with a good product and overnight they want to go national. Food is a very, very regional thing, very, very local thing. So I always tell the young entrepreneur, if you want to build a food brand, make a good product, use latest packaging technology. Logistic. First, establish your brand in your city, then your districts, then adjoining districts. Unless you get double figure market share in your local, don't expect to the next city. Expect to the next city. Once you have built market, a brand in a state, then add three state, four, then think about national. But unfortunately, what happens is these problem is today is our equity market or share market where people invest, IPO will be successful if your brand is national. Otherwise, nobody is going to invest. And that is why most of, and naturally, so thinly spread, so much investments in brand building, advertising, you are not able to pass value either to the suppliers or to the
I think those are fantastic inputs, and in fact, I really appreciate Mr. Sodhi that, you know, being the market leader, you are giving so much insight to younger entrepreneurs who would want to look at food and processed food and dairy products industry sectors. You are actually inviting competition to come on and do more, but I think that's the magnanimity of your heart and, you know, the approach of your organization that has always done wonders for our country.
I like to add, you see, in the beginning I said marketing or branding is a tool which we have used for development of the our milk producers or the farmers. More the people, more transparency, more competition, because farmer is going to get choice and better price for their products. And that will achieve our objective. We are in the business of milk or business of dairy. We are in the business of development of milk farmers. So if more people get better price, good for us. We achieve our objective.
I think that's a very laudable approach. So I think before I open up the floor to the audience, there's one question that is really bugging me inside, and I think that's the hot topic of conversation in every marketing, media, industry meeting that you go to these days. Is there's this whole sense of concern, apprehension, what will happen with this demonetization thing. You hear marketers talking about the fact that they are pulling out their campaigns, you know, applying brakes. You see consumers not only being strapped of cash and hence not being able to buy products, but the whole propensity to buy, the willingness to buy, has somehow got shaken to the core because consumers are now wanting to hoard cash and, you know, even those 100 rupee notes, they are wanting to keep in their back pocket rather than spend it out. How do marketers deal with this phenomenon and what's the way forward now?
You see, in Amul, this demonetization has affected both sides of our C2C business, farmer side also and consumer side. But let me tell you, my answer will be opposite to the most of the people sitting here. Very contrary. When this was announced, so first few days we also said there is a problem, how farmers will get money for the milk they are supplying. Because every week, nowadays 450 crore rupees we are disbursing in cash to the farmers. So when this demonetization, how to give cash? How farmers buy vegetable, how they'll pay the fee? Everybody might. And just last week I had my board meeting. And on my board, I'm the only professional. My 18 board members are farmers. They are chairman of the district union, but they are milk producers. They don't understand the intricacy of the business. But I thought they'll cry, they'll shout the board meeting, government ne kya kar diya, farm. Because money was not going to the villages. It had stopped. But surprisingly, everybody said, "Arre, hum jo pichhe 10 saal se nahi kar pa rahe the, it ek stroke mein ho gaya." What is that? What is that? We have been trying that whatever money we are paying to the farmers, instead of giving cash, it should be credited to their bank account. But due to the vested interest at the village level, it was not happening. Because the village, the cooperative society fellow, he was disbursing cash. And in parallel, he had that day lane ka vyapar. If somebody has taken advance, usko jab bill bhi aayega, usme se apna interest kaat ke de dega. And money also used to be of village cooperative society also. And whenever we try to push the thing, they used to create some obstacles here and there. Kuch na kuch problem kare. But with this coming, when money is not there, so they were forced to deposit money or credit money in individual's bank account. And under Jan Dhan Yojana and other things, more than 50% farmers already had the account. But it was not linked. Accounts were not linked to the milk payment. So they were forced to do it. And second, those farmers who had no accounts, certain their lives will not get the money unless you open account. So they started opening account. After 8th November and today, we have opened more than 3.5 lakh accounts. Earlier we had 30 lakh accounts, then this, and really small farmers now getting cash. That 24,000, now 50,000. But other problem was there. Cash is not coming to the villages. And especially this, most of the accounts are in district cooperative banks, and district cooperative banks were not getting cash. So then we have to take up the matter with the RBI. And because of farmer's name and Amul name, RBI agreed to give us through district cooperative special money, cash to be disbursed for the milk payment. But let me tell you, last 3 weeks, our total bill may be around 1,350 crore rupees. And only we have received 300 or 400 crore rupees in cash. Still, there is no event plan. So that is the positive impact, which we never expected. Now, what it has brought to us is, first is transparency in the system. So now farmer know what is credit. Second is that savings happened. Now, otherwise we used to give weekly payment, the farmer used to get full payment and used to spend it here and there. Now he is going to, or she is going to figure out what is necessary. And third is his or her credit worthiness. So I counted, they can take loan from the bank now. consumer side, which most of the, I read in the all the pink papers that 20, 30, 50% down, maybe right. But let me tell you, and you are the consumer, you know, in milk or other fresh product, not a single rupee reduction in sale. Some of the discretionary product, ice creams, beverages, cheese, we faced little lull in first 1 week. Second week became normal. Third week, whatever we have lost in the first 3 weeks. So average sale which we closed 2 days back is around 20% higher than the last one. Why? Because you see, have you reduced consumption any of our dairy product? You are not reduced. It may impact the durables or nothing, but as for food or FMCG products are there which are not discretionary, it is not going to impact. We talk a lot.
So your core message to marketers would be to stay positive and keep pressing for better times to come ahead. I think it's a temporary phase, as you pointed out. Thank you so much, Mr. Sodhi. I think it's been extremely wonderful. I think I'll open up the floor for maximum of 2 audience questions. We are running a little behind schedule in terms of time. I know you want tons of information, and I'm requesting Mr. Sodhi, if he's around, post this keynote address. Some of you could perhaps meet him later in the evening and, you know, get that question out of your mind. So I'll open up the floor to 2 questions, please.
Thank you so much, Mr. Dwivedi. We've got ushers in the room. Request you to please raise your hand, identify yourself and the organization that you represent, and ask the pointed question. While we wait for questions from the audience, I definitely do have one question. So, Sodhi, aisa hai ki, internationally, there's a very strong movement in veganism. Primarily, you know, it's also very well supported by the PETA in terms of, you know, organizations using animals and animal products as far as, you know, their consumer products are concerned. Or primary concern yehi hai with the way animals are literally abused and exploited for, you know, for profit margins. While I understand that Amul is a cooperative and not really a corporation, but is there any process or any thought that goes into this as far as Amul is concerned in terms of, you know, good treatment to the animals?
See, I was just 1.5 months I was in Rotterdam, International Dairy Federation conference was there. There is a company in USA which is certifying dairy farm where animals, are kept without any cruelty. And the lady was promoting that we all should get certified third party certification that we are keeping animal very nicely and very clean, and feeding them well and doing everything. I asked her only one question. What are you doing once the cow stops getting milk? You send it to slaughterhouse. So, what do you mean by cruelty? I mean, you, it is like aap usko pura mila mila raho, baad mein bech nahi kahi. So, as far as this thing is, you see, these things, these are the moment it comes and go. People talk on these things. Like, I mean, latest controversy you have been hearing that butter fat or dairy fat is saturated fat, is not good, cholesterol is bad. Now everybody is talking, there is no linkage of cholesterol with the heart or blood pressure. Last 50 years, people have been selling medicines and other things. But in Amul, let me tell you, in India, as well as no cow slaughter is bad.
And what about as far as, so while I appreciate you saying that there is a certain kind of fad which comes across as far as this is concerned, but also we can't defy reality in terms of how animals are misused. And you know, I've personally seen
in India, animals are family members. You go to our villages, farmers are keeping 1-2 cows in their home only. They are the member, they have got names.
I think that concludes question number 1. Subhanna, you took one out of the audience, so we'll have to give one to the audience.
Yes.
Go ahead,
right,
please.
Right here. Sodhi ji, thanks for doing this, coming all the way and enlightening us. I have a Very straightforward and crude question, something that a lot of people in the media are bothered about these days. I'll be direct. Is Amul planning to spend, cut spends, advertising spends because of demonetization? Are you planning to increase? Is there some good news for us?
Which initiative?
No, I think this is a good time to spend more and get us discounts from you people because others are not spending.
So is Amul going to increase spends?
Yeah, yeah, we'll keep it 20-30% discount, we'll double the budget.
Sir, it'll be very difficult to create such conference.
We are spending only 0.8% of turnovers, so what are you cutting? There's no need. And business is as usual, so I don't think so.
So
20% discount and you get more spend from Apple. That's the story.
So Mr. Dwivedi, considering that E4M has literally hogged both the question, ek aur opportunity de dete hain, one question. Yes.
Could you just identify yourself and then ask the question, please?
I'm Dr. Virendra Singh.
Yes, Dr. Singh.
So my question is that Amul is really a cooperative organization looking for the health of the young people. So I request out of your CSR, maybe to all organized sector, open a laboratory in every district to identify what kind of the things are being mixed in the local milk by the Doodhwala, maybe the urea, maybe the soap, maybe the oil, so that the people become health conscious and they will have more trust and faith in all organized, maybe the Amul, maybe the Vita.
Sir, is there a question or is there a suggestion? We are happy to take a question.
No, I am asking how they are spending the CSR for this.
So on CSR, how does Amul look at
yes.
spending? Sir, thank you very much, Najib. We don't have CSR budget. I mean, we don't have profits, so naturally 2% is nothing. Our whole organization is CSR.
Fantastic, I think. That's
coming to this adulteration issue, it's a very important issue. Government has got their machinery to check the adulteration, etc. But as Amul, I think in the one of this TV cabinet, we have shown what type of four tests we conduct when during our whole supply chain. First is that the village level farmers is giving electronically qualities tested for any adulteration. Second is that milk and it is immediately cooled in bulk together. Second is that milk reaches the factory, there again it is checked for any adulteration quality because en route if something has happened. Then third is before packing and fourth is before dispatch in the market. I mean we are having four stages of checks. And that is why it is very, very, for a brand like Amul, essential.
Sir, my question is not that for the Amul.
Sir, thank you so much. I guess we will probably
No, we are not going to spend for the laboratories all over India. We don't have money.
But I think that was a good suggestion. I think from the approach of Amul standpoint, Mr. Sodhi has been kind enough to take a lot more questions than what we had anticipated. Mr. Sodhi, thank you so much for a very enlightening presentation and for taking all the audience questions as well. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you so much, Mr. Sodhi, Mr. Dwivedi. Request you to please stay back. We'd like to offer you a token of appreciation. Request Mr. Dwivedi to please hand that over on behalf of the Exchange for Media Group. With a loud round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. R.S. Sodhi, Managing Director, Amul.